demonstrate the centrifugal pump. So in this, we are going to determine the efficiency of the centrifugal pump, that is pump efficiency and overall efficiency of the centrifugal pump. So first of all, we'll discuss what is a centrifugal pump. So when the hydraulic machines which converts mechanical energy into hydraulic energy is called as pump. So here hydraulic energy means it is in the form of pressure energy. If the mechanical energy converted into hydraulic energy in the form of centrifugal force acting on the field, and that hydraulic machine is called as centrifugal pump. So there are major four parts of the centrifugal pump. First one is the casing, second one is the impeller, third one is suction pipe, fourth one is the impeller, fourth one is the railway. Let me explain first the first part, that is casing. So in this part is called as casing. This is the covering, is the casing. Inside that there is a impeller. So casing, which will just act like a surrounding cover for the impeller. Second part is that impeller. Inside this casing there is an impeller, and impeller consists of backward curved vanes, and that curved vanes which will lift the water when the shaft which rotates. So shaft of the impeller which is connected to the shaft of the electric motor. So this portion is electric motor, and the shaft of the electric motor which is connected to the shaft of the impeller, and when shaft rotated, the curved vanes consist of, the series of curved vanes consist of impeller that is also rotated, and that will lift the water. So some pressure head created, and because of the pressure head we can able to lift the water up to a required height. Then the suction pipe, this portion is suction pipe. So a pipe, its one end is connected to the input of the pump. So this is the input of the pump, and another end connected to the sump. So here there is a water is there, so another end which is connected to the sump. So there is a foot valve which is connected to the end of the suction pipe. So it is also called as non-return valve or one-way valve. And one more part is that the delivery pipe. So this part portion is delivery pipe. So output of the pump which is connected to the one end of the delivery pipe, and another end which is connected to deliver water up to required height. So there is a valve which is connected here, and up to required height we can able to lift the water. So these are the main four parts: casing, impeller, suction pipe and delivery pipe. Experiment we have to do priming. What do you mean by priming? First of all, so priming means so filling up of the water inside the casing, that means removal of the entrapped air inside the casing by filling water inside the casing through this valve. So when it is gets filled, all the air which is present inside this casing will be removed, then we can start the pump. So that procedure is called as priming. Is completely filled with water, is filled or not, we can see through this particular small valve here, water which is coming out of the small hole from the casing. Before starting of the experiment, we have to do some initial adjustment. So here there is a dynamometer. So we have to balance that dynamometer. We can see here, so this spring balance is not equal, which is not coincide with this reading, this pointer. So we have to make it balance. So that will be possible through, there is a valve like thing here. So you can rotate that and bring the entire balance to the same level. We can see it is almost level now, almost leveled. So like that way we can able to balance it. And this is the dynamometer. So here we can get the readings in terms of kgs, and that is very important to calculate the torque. And one more thing we need to note, that so this pointer should be exactly to the zero. If it is not, use this small T to bring the pointer to zero. So this is the initial adjustment we have to do before starting of the experiment. Determine the performance of the centrifugal pump under constant speed condition and to draw the performance and to draw the characteristic curve. So for the constant speed condition, that means it may be for 1000 rpm or for 1500 rpm, we have to check the performance of this particular centrifugal pump and by varying the discharge. So here, after keeping the speed to a constant value, say 1500 rpm, we have to take some readings. So here we have current meter reading. So this reading we have to take. Then in this particular display, we can able to set the speed of the pump in terms of rpm. I can able to set to 1500 rpm or 2000 rpm. This is the knob to vary the rpm speed. And here we can note the voltmeter reading. This is the delivery head in terms of kg per centimeter square. And below there is a suction head in mm of mercury. This particular gauge for to measure the suction head in terms of mm of mercury. And one more reading we need to note, that is a dynamometer reading. Here we can able to see it is in terms of kg, and that is required to calculate the torque. And finally, we have to find out the actual discharge. That will be through collecting tank method. So actual discharge through collecting tank method. So area of the collecting tank into height divided by time. So for a particular tank, for a 10 centimeter raise in water level inside the tank, how much time is required? So that is going to be possible. So collecting tank method is to calculate the actual discharge. This is the tabular column. So trials, the second column is speed of the pump N in RPM, revolution per minute. So this is set to 1000 RPM or 1500 RPM. We can set to any speed, but it is constant for all the trials. If it is 8 trials are there, for all the 8 trials it is 1500 RPM only. Next one, we have to note delivery pressure in kg per centimeter square. Then suction pressure PV in mm of mercury. Voltmeter reading in volts. Current meter readings in amperes. Height of water in collecting tank in meter. It is usually 10 centimeter. Time taken for rise of H in collecting tank, that is in seconds. So this much readings we have to take it from the apparatus. And from here onwards, we have to calculate the total head, actual discharge, force exerted in kg. This is also through the dynamometer reading. From the apparatus we have to take it. Then torque, T is equal to F into 9.81 into 0.11. So this F is force exerted, that is dynamometer reading. Next we have to calculate motor input, motor output, pump output, pump efficiency and overall efficiency. So now we have to set the speed of the pump to 1500 rpm. 1500 rpm I am going to take it. So by using this knob, I can able to fix the speed of the pump. So here now 1700 is there. So use this knob to vary the speed. So I have to set the speed of the pump to 1500 exactly. The pump is set to 1500 rpm. Plus or minus 5 or 10, there is no problem. And here you have to keep the discharge at maximum position. So the valve position should be open, completely open. And you have to note the readings, current meter reading, voltmeter reading, delivery head, suction head and dynamometer reading. This much readings you have to note it. The speed of the pump is 1500 rpm. Then we have to note the current meter reading, that is 1.04. Current meter reading here we have, it is 0.08 we can take. Next one is voltmeter reading, it is 117. So voltmeter reading in volts, it is 117. Next, delivery head, we have delivery pressure in kg per centimeter square. The delivery head in kg per centimeter square, so here it is almost 0.1 kg per centimeter square. It is just above the zero, therefore it is 0.1 centimeter square. So just note down that reading, delivery head as 0.1. Next one is the suction pressure PV in mm of mercury. So this gauge, and you have to note from this line to here. So the outer black one is the mm of mercury, and inside red one is the inch of mercury. So we want outer circle. So 0 to 100 is there. This pointer gauge, which is exactly pointed to 80. So you can write it to 80. So we have to note down the force exerted in kg, F. So this is the dynamometer, and the values are in kg. So 0 to 1, 2, 3, up to 10 kg is there. So now the force exerted is almost 350 grams. That means 0.35 kg. So note it as force exerted 0.35 kg. To calculate the actual discharge, that is through correction tank method, and to calculate the actual discharge we need time. So before, to start that, you just close the collecting tank valve so that there is no water flowing below the tank. So rise in the water level in this piezometer takes place, and for 10 centimeter height, what is the time required, that you need to note it. Taken to raise 10 cm height inside the collecting tank is 25.79 seconds. So that you have to note it in the table of column. That is 25.79 seconds for a 10 cm height. So 0.1 is in meter. I will explain one set of calculation here. First of all, total head, H is equal to 10 into PD plus PV by 760. PD is delivery head, PV is suction pressure. So here we have the data, delivery pressure and suction pressure, PD and PV, 0.1 and 80. So substitute that value in that equation, 10 into 0.1 plus 80 by 760, and total head is 2.05 meter. Next, we need to calculate actual discharge. The formula is area of the collecting tank into height divided by time. So area of the collecting tank, which is given in the apparatus itself, that is 0.26 meter square, and height is 10 centimeter, so 0.1 meter, and time is, we have noted, that is 25.79. The actual discharge is 1.008 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube per second. Next, torque. The formula is F into 9.81 into 0.11. So this is the arm radius. So F is force exerted, that is a dynamometer reading in kg. So that is, we have noted in the table of column, that is 0.35 kg. So substitute that value, 0.35 into 9.81 into 0.11, the answer is 0.377 nano newton meter. Next, we have to calculate the motor input. The formula is voltage into current divided by 1000. So we have noted down, we have noted the voltmeter reading here, that is 117, then current meter reading in amperes, that is 1.08. Substitute that value to the equation. So 117 into 1.08 divided by 1000, the answer is 0.126 kilowatt. So this is in kilowatt, therefore we have divided by 1000. If it is not divided by 1000, that will be in terms of watts. Next, motor output or pump input, both are one and the same. The formula is 2 pi nt by 60,000. So n is the speed of the pump, t is the torque produced. So here we have answer. So n is the constant, 1500. So the answer is 0.059 kilowatt. Next, we have to calculate pump output. The formula is rho gq actual into h divided by 1000. So rho is the density of water,
g is 9.81, acceleration due to gravity, q actual we have calculated above here. This is the actual discharge. Then h is total head, 2.05 meter. This is the total head. Substitute that value into the equation and finally you will get pump output, that is 0.0202 kilowatt. Finally, we have to calculate the efficiency. First one is the pump efficiency. The formula is pump output by pump input into 100. It is in percentage. So substitute the value, you will get efficiency of the pump. Next, we have to calculate overall efficiency. The formula is pump output by motor input into 100. So 16.03%. So this is the one set of calculation which is shown here. For the rest, for all the other trials, calculate the same and fill the table or column.